touch with our inner woman on the Lilith Fair tour. And in between, we rocked to Radiohead and Rage, got synthesized by Beck and Moby, and swayed to the musings of Lauryn Hill. Albums like 10, Supernatural, Ray of Light, Millennium, and The Chronic shaped the decade and gave us music for a lifetime. Today's topic, best album of the 90s. Welcome to a special one-hour edition of The List. Here's how it works. Each of our guests have brought their top three picks, and they'll defend those choices before our audience picks the top three best albums of the 90s. We will also hear from you across America, logged on VH1.com. And we've got a special performance by one of the hottest new bands around, Stir, singing their hit single, The Beginning. I'm Katie Lang, this is VH1, and you are on The List. Knows a thing or two about making great albums. He's a founding member of one of the hottest bands of the 90s with some great albums of their own like A Boy Named Goo and Dizzy Up the Girl. From the Goo Goo Dolls, please welcome Robby Takac.
Yeah. Hello.
Welcome. Our next guest is a very busy actor. You know him from the WB hit Felicity and can catch him on the upcoming thriller Hollow Man. Please put your hands together and welcome the very talented Greg Grunberg. Also joining us is a very funny and sexy lady. You know her from Fox's In Living Color and her appearances on The Tonight Show. And you can catch her in her feature film, Live Virgins. Please help me welcome my good friend, Alexandra Wentworth. You know our last guest. He's the lead singer from the legendary metal group Iron Maiden. Yes! Their new album, Brave New World, is coming out soon. Please give it up for the one and only Bruce Dickinson. Now, before we get going, let's take a look at some of the albums that defined the 90s.
To me, a 90s album probably has to have more technology, because that's what they do in the 90s.
The best album of the 90s is Siamese Dreams by Smashing Pumpkins.
The best album of the 90s is Hello Nasty by the Beastie Boys.
The best album of the 90s is probably U2's Octone Baby.
To me, one of the greatest albums of the 90s is probably Nirvana, Nevermind, because it really ushered in the 90s.
The best 90s album is Pearl Jam's 10 because every song kicks ass and Eddie Vedder's one of the best, most emotional singers ever.
Crazy Sexy Cool.
These Crowded Streets.
Cypress Hill self-titled. Mirror Vault. Totally. The Chronic.
40 Ounces to Freedom.
The Score by the Fugees.
The best album of the 90s has got to be Californication by the Red Hot Chili Peppers because Flea rocks.
With our guest choices, and Robby, you're number one.
I'm first.
Let's start with you. What's your third choice?
Okay, well, the best album of the 90s. When I was asked, I was kept up. Well, I wasn't kept up. Not really. I wasn't kept up, but I was intrigued by it. Because I came to find after looking at a lot of my records and things that the 90s seemed to be more of a decade of maintenance for music, more so than a huge progressive step like the
70s and 80s. Keeping sort of sounds going?
I just
going,
think it sort of took sort of what was going, yeah, and sort of expanded upon it, as opposed to, you know, new mind-blowing
brand
things
new
happening. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So in keeping with that, my number three record is The Downward Spiral by Nine Inch Nails.
Heaven.
Wow.
would that be defining?
Well, that's defining about one thousandth of what is on that record, which is why I think that's a great record.
And what is that like regurgitating?
That is a lot of noise. And,
regurgitating noise?
Yeah, that's regurgitating noise.
Okay, and, well, I'll accept
that. I think that there was a lot of very noisy sort of industrial sort of sounding things that have happened.
Right.
And I think that sort of added a lot of musicality to it.
Okay, Greg.
Well, I have
your
to say,
third choice.
Yeah, best album of the 90s. First of all, it's hard. It was a really tough choice because not enough time has gone by. I think it's easy to kind of look at the 70s and pick something out that was influential because you can see how it's influenced so many other things. I mean, if you had a 90s party now, what, you know.
It's probably happening. Everything's
right. Everyone would show up in stonewashed jeans or something. I don't know what exactly would be like the mark of a 90s party. But this guy, when I first heard his music, it blew me away. I didn't think he would look anything like what he looks like. He's a nerd who rocks the house so hard, and he's really studied, and he's just an incredible musician. Takes so many influences and puts them together in a really original way, and I think influences so many other artists. Has to be Beck with Odelay. Come on!
Yeah, definitely. I think this is a good example of an original, for sure.
Yeah, definitely
an original.
And I think big thumbs up.
Yeah, big thumbs up.
Yeah, we're still going to be listening to this guy and that album. You know, it's something that everyone's going to be playing forever.
Okay, I like you now. You're okay with me now.
Thank you.
Okay, Miss Wentworth.
Well, that's actually my card he took from me.
You can roll that back tape.
Well, I had a tough time with the 90s being a teenager. And all. We listen to a lot of music. All right, I'm 52, but the point is.
Me too.
I found the 90s a hard decade for music because I think the 60s and 70s, even the 80s, were very kind of definitive. In the 90s, I sort of had a hard time with what defines that era of music. And I was going to, of course, Constant Craving, but then everyone said, no, that it seems like you want to sleep with KD.
Well, you do.
I do.
I know.
Who doesn't? But I wanted to be a little more subtle, so I'll hit on you after the show. So my third choice is OK Computer Radiohead.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Really good.
Oh, look it. The Englishman doesn't approve. Come on, your thoughts.
No, it's just that I could have picked Radiohead and Nirvana and a whole bunch of things. So it's.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No,
let's hear what you picked then.
It's a little late now, my friend.
It's not that. No, I kind of.
Iron Maiden?
No.
This is my second choice.
No, I wasn't in the band in the 90s. I quit.
Oh.
But then you were a teenager, so you wouldn't have known.
That's right. I have no idea who you are.
But, I mean, the No, I have the same problem. I mean, but the deal is, I mean, I sort of was quite surprised when I got asked to pick the best band of the 90s because I'm like, I don't
best
know.
Album,
I
best album.
Best album, best whatever. Because I don't even care, you know.
Just go. Just get off my shoulder.
I was like, you know, well, I can think of the most influential. It's kind of meaningless.
Well, it's like the Academy Awards.
It's like there's loads of great stuff, and who do you pick? So I just pick stuff that.
But defining, I think we can reword the show. Defining albums. You don't even have to like them, but what defined the 90s?
Oh, okay. No, well, I didn't do that. So I mean, I just picked.
So you're just bollocks all the way through.
Yeah, I was just like, well, I pick. You know. In fact.
I know who you are now.
Yeah, exactly. You know why I'm on the show.
Yes.
I'm the one you love to hate.
You're great.
Yeah. So.
They put angry guy next to TNA girl.
Yeah. That's right. And we got celebrity deathmatch before you know it. You know what I mean? Anyway, so. I picked a band called Catherine Wheel, who, mainly nepotism, actually, because my cousin's a singer, but they're a great band.
Well, I noticed that the audience didn't respond to that at all.
No, that's right. No, they wouldn't expect them to, because the record company who had them back in the 90s did a terrible, terrible job of marketing
them. And who
them.
Would that be? What company?
That would, well, if I said it was mercury poisoning, you get it from fillings, it might be a clue.
Uh-huh, but,
I mean,
yeah, right.
The, the deal was that they were extremely influential on a whole bunch of musicians, other musicians, a lot of other bands that actually, influenced, let's be charitable, by the stuff that that band did early on. And they are a really, really classic band that nobody knows about.
This is your cousin's band.
Yeah, it's your cousin's band.
My cousins have a band, too.
Exactly.
I didn't know we were doing bands. I'll do an album.
Has your cousin done, like, about 7 albums?
Maybe you've heard of my cousin, Mick.
What's your name? Mick?
Okay, Great Big so far.
There's no genetic likeness.
What is Great Big so far? When we come back, our panelists' second choices. We'll be right back.
The Jagger thing.
This special one-hour edition of The List. We've already heard our panelists' third choices for best album of the 90s, and now it's time to hear from you, the people of America. God bless you. From Henrietta, I love Lenny Kravitz. And he had 3 great albums in the 90s, Mama Said, 5, and You Are Gonna Go My Way. Lenny rules in the 90s and forever.
Yes, Henrietta!
Somebody loves to shout some Lenny.
Absolutely.
Here's one from Alyssa. Listen up, VH1. I mean, come on. Everyone who is cool knows that the best album of the 90s is Significant Other from Limp Bizkit. Nookie is the best party song ever. And the rest of the CD kicks ass.
There you go.
Limp Bizkit. Who knew?
Lenny Kravitz, though.
Lenny Kravitz.
That's a great call.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Although he was sort of stuck in another decade.
Not anymore. He cut his dreads off. He's looking handsome.
Really?
Is that the email?
I'm only going to read 2 emails right now.
You didn't read mine?
Ellie.
Okay. Ellie.
I'm sorry. Okay. It's time to get our guest second choice.
Okay. Second choice. I could have said Radiohead, and I did. But it's not OK Computer. It's the Bends. Radiohead, the Bends.
Radiohead is, to me, unbelievable because of their melodic sense.
Well, the thing I love about the records the most, and this is kind of why I picked the 90s Nails record as well, is because you can actually listen to that record from the beginning until the end.
Right, which is an old style.
Well, you feel like you've heard
making.
Something when the record's done. You know, it's not like, you know, just a bunch of filler
You're
and
going
then two
for the
songs
single.
That might be on the radio, which right. I think the 90s were.
Yeah, kind of single oriented. Radio record companies, if you're listening, we don't want to make single oriented albums anymore. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay, for number 2, this female vocalist, she's absolutely incredible. She says whatever the hell she wants to say in such a great way. Her second album also had, I think it was her second album, it's got her standing naked in the middle of the street, although she can't get a cab. I had to go.
You know what? That video was terrible.
Who is it?
Alanis Morissette, Jagged Little Pill.
Are you selecting that one because it only sold 19 million domestically?
Exactly. I'm commerce driven. I think she's got a unique sound.
It was. You know what? Whether you liked it or not, it connected with the people in a major way, and that, it did define the 90s in a way, especially for women.
Thank you.
Wow, we're moving right along from that pick. I said, and this is probably personal, but I think that for me and most of my women friends that had nervous breakdowns in the 90s, Natalie Merchant, Tiger Lily.
Yeah.
Well, I really have nothing to say about that.
Well, is that a good thing? I guess.
Not bad.
Alanis sold a lot more albums.
That's kind of your Catherine Wheel thing, isn't it?
What?
It's kind of your Catherine Wheel thing.
My Catherine Wheel?
What kind
wheel.
Of thing? Wheel.
She's Catherine throwing it back
wheel.
At you. Oh, I don't know. It got me through
I'm
a really
sure
hard time.
No. Well, no, but that's absolutely great. It's
okay,
your,
Iron
it's your
Maiden,
favorite album.
Let's have your second choice. It's not my favorite.
You think it's your
just
best?
Defining.
Defining.
Yeah.
For the 90s for you.
No, Iron Maiden is my favorite. This is my defining album.
We're getting through here, you know?
Mr. Dickinson.
Bad Motorfinger, Soundgarden. There you go, it rocks. That's all you have to say.
We're going to take a short break. Let's take a long one.
Yeah,
let's take a long one. We're going
to
take a long break.
I mean, just whatever you need to do.
We're going to take a really long break. We're going to get our panelists' first choices, and I can hardly wait for that. And then we're going to move on to our viewers. We'll be right back. A special edition of The List. So far, we've gotten our guests' third and second choices for best album of the 90s. Now, let's hear some of your thoughts via email from Audra. This is going to be a little bit of a bone of contention, Audra, I hate to say. I think Millennium by the Backstreet Boys should be on the list.
Please.
Why aren't the Backstreet Boys taken seriously?
You go, Audra!
Oh, shut up!
They
what are you talking
good
about?
Good artists, and this CD shows that they have grown as artists.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Okay. Backstreet Boys. Okay, what do we think
right.
of
just like a commercial.
What do we
same thing.
What do we think of
the Backstreet Boys? They are the Rolling Stones, the Doors of the 90s.
You are so funny. You are so funny.
That's insane.
Oh, you don't have to try that hard, really.
I'm just being controversial.
I think NSYNC.
I asked you to pump up the volume.
No, NSYNC, these guys, all these bands, I mean, look, God bless. They're all working so hard.
No, you know what it is?
You know what I got to say? I just can't stand it because they don't have any backbone, nothing behind them. One of the songs, I think it's NSYNC, starts off, it's like, oh my God, we're back again. It's like, what? What is that?
How did that go again?
You heard me.
You know what it is? You know how these things work? Record companies or managers or whoever just decide they're going to create a band and wham.
Wham?
Wham. And wham.
You know, Backstreet Boys. You were saying that they suck, right?
Yeah.
Well, your daughter happens to like the Backstreet Boys.
She'll grow out of it, I'm sure.
Maybe
you know?
She won't.
You know,
maybe she'll marry a Backstreet Boy.
I know, but my daughter, bless her heart, is five. You know?
But they say children
Let's
are very
Let's call the audience. Audience, what do you think of the Backstreet Boys?
I want to know who's buying these records, man.
I'm sorry. This is like Billy, don't be a hero and stuff.
Yeah, right.
It's like paper lace and all this
it's
stuff.
It's always been around.
Tie a yellow ribbon. It's the same equivalent in the 90s, from the 80s, from the 70s.
Yeah. Well, Tony Orlando, let's stop that.
Tin Pan Alley.
Come on, Tony Orlando had something going on. I agree. You know.
Well,
oh, no,
there's always been super middle-of-the-road pop that sells to the masses. But let's make room for some artists again, folks. Now, the moment you have all been waiting for, on the edge of your seat, our guest number one choices for best album of the 90s, Robby.
Okay, here we go. Best album of the 90s, I believe this record in particular stopped a horribly bad time for music and pretty much buried 99.9% of the hair bands that were out there during the 80s.
Like Iron Maiden?
No, Iron Maiden was not a hair band.
No, we
weren't. They had hair, as do I.
Yeah,
Maiden
wasn't a hair band, actually.
No, not at all.
We were getting kind of pissed off at the whole...
Right.
The whole, you know, the whole ridiculous kind of thing.
I saw your knee twitch. That's the only reason I threw it to you.
Right. If he was going to say I was going to kill
it.
Was
your body language?
You know, in the 80s,
we weren't that. At the end of the 80s, they actually screwed it up for everybody. The record companies churning out. And I have to say, there's so. I'm amazed how many guys sing like Kurt Cobain in the 90s. I was
absolutely.
So within 6 or 9 months of Nirvana coming out, it was just like boom, boom, boom. Out come all these clones, and it just kind of gags me really because it's a shame.
I have a question.
You know? Yes.
And this is. Maybe just because I'm blonde. what's a hair band? Guys with long hair?
Hair band. Poison.
Poison.
No,
like heavy metal?
Yeah.
It's a bit more. It's a,
you know, Bon Jovi, the way Bon Jovi look.
It's
you know,
sort of like the rock
hair band.
Okay.
Guys with big... Guys that look like girls
hair.
Playing heavy metal.
Yeah, it's sort of like the rock version of the Backstreet Boys.
Right.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
We never got to your first choice.
No, but I think everybody pretty much knows what it is,
correct? So hair band means shallow.
Right.
Hair band in the context he's using it basically means shallow.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
All right. Just making sure.
Okay. Let's get to
the hair band.
Robby's first choice. Allie.
Number one.
People.
Number
Robby's
one.
Number one choice.
Most important, most listenable, and just it rocks really, really hard. Is Nirvana's Nevermind.
Yeah! Pretty important record. Definitely set the tone for the 90s.
Definitely defining. Yeah.
Is anything else defining?
Can't argue with that.
Nope. I wish I could disagree. Yeah,
so I picked both.
What?
I picked both, Nirvana and Radiohead, man.
Oh, yeah, well, that's right. Well, that's why I didn't pick Nirvana or Radiohead, because I knew somebody would.
Yeah.
I was like, you know,
I think that my first pick is definitely... Not everyone's going to agree
nervous,
with me.
I am nervous because I
love this guy and what he did for his area of music. Just changed it. He brought it back.
Kenny G.
No, not Kenny G. He brought it back in such a huge way. One of the, I think, all-time selling albums in
John
the history.
Tesh.
Yes, John Tesh. No, I mean, and I saw him live, and he rocks so hard. Plus, you know, if he can make it as a sex symbol, I got a shot. So
Billy Squire.
No, you're not gonna believe it. The album is No Fences and it's Garth Brooks. Sorry.
Okay.
you warned us, you set a disclaimer and said you're going commercial all the way in your picks, and damn it if you didn't go ahead and do it.
Yeah. He's got some backbone to him though. I think Garth's got some backbone. You don't agree?
Well, he's got more than backbone, that's for sure.
That's kind of off the wall, but...
Yeah, well, you know, you're brave.
Well, no, it wasn't rock album, right?
Yeah. No, it didn't have to be. It didn't have to be.
You could go folk, or religious, or...
That opens it up for me. That's
Export.
True. You don't have to agree.
No, none of us do.
God.
None of us do.
I think that's the same bet.
It's okay. Actually. Allie?
Oh, God, thank God I'm following that.
Thanks, Allie.
Well, Again, if you're having a nervous breakdown.
19.
Did you have a rough decade?
I'm 18. I've had a lot of nervous breakdowns.
And your dad had a 19th nervous breakdown, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
My number one album was... Sorry.
Mick?
Your
dad.
No, that's weird to name
his
my
cousin.
Dad.
That was a cousin, I think.
It was my cousin, but he's also my dad.
You come from the south.
Okay.
It's the family resemblance. Yeah.
Right. And I just had his baby, but anyway.
So did everybody else.
I know. You know, beggars can't be choosers. Okay, my number one album is Tidal by Fiona Apple.
Oh!
That was your number one?
Yeah, because she's so skinny.
Okay. You got me there.
Yeah.
Number one skinniest artist.
What's wrong with Tori Amos? What's good with Tori Amos? Because Tori Amos, I mean, if I'd known all these girl bands were going to be in here with the girl things, I would have picked Tori. I should have picked Tori as one of my picks,
Fiona was definitely one of the defining women in the 90s, but I don't think she would have been number one defining.
Whoa, sister. Whoa, those are fighting words.
I mean, there was a record in 1992 that blew everybody out of the water.
Well, it's too obvious to say.
Knew.
Okay. Honey, that would be my number one if it wasn't so obvious.
I know. That's what I hate about being the damn host.
Well, right. We can't say any of your albums.
Exactly.
Fiona Apple, huh?
All right. Fiona Apple. I mean, Katie Lang, Constant Craving. But yeah, Fiona Apple.
That's okay.
I hate Fiona Apple. Who is Fiona Apple? No.
Right. Shirley Manson is the singer of the band that I picked. So, Garbage version 2,
oh,
I picked.
Yeah. Yeah.
Production on this record is great.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is like a band that actually I think genuinely does have a shot at one of the best bands of the 90s. No, she's not, funnily enough. No. But it's just a great bunch of songs, really, really well produced. And for a decade of bands that sounded an awful lot like Nirvana and copied an awful lot of Nirvana and that whole hair shirt, you know, oh, we're so pissed off and miserable, you know, type stuff, you know. They came out, it was like a breath of fresh air, just great songs, you know, really, really
song,
sassy,
yeah.
And, you know, it's great.
Okay, we've got 12 great picks coming up. Our panelists put their gloves on and knock out 4 from the list, my favorite part. Elimination round. Also, a special performance from an exciting new band, Stir, so don't go anywhere. The list. So far, we've heard each of our panelists' top 3 picks for best album of the 90s. Now, let's hear your opinions. And here's an email that really brings up an amazing point that I can't believe there's been such a huge void in our discussion so far, and that is rap and hip-hop's popularity in the 90s,
yeah,
because it was absolutely undeniable. And this email points out Dog Style, Snoop Dogg, Fear of a Black Planet, Public Enemy, All Eyes on Me, Tupac, and No Way Out, Puff Daddy.
Yeah.
And not to mention The Chronic, Dr. Dre, and Laurel Hill,
yeah.
Lauryn Hill, Miss Education.
That's my email.
Oh, this is your,
yeah, I sent it.
Oh, you are down. Okay. But, you know, that's true. And then, I you know, as I travel all over the world, the influence of rap and hip-hop all around the world is undeniable.
It really is.
I guess I was sort of looking for the more defining things that changed hip-hop. And I think most of those, when I looked at those sort of records, tend to be from the late 80s, you know.
Uh-huh.
I think there's an audience that likes that kind of stuff, and there's people like me. I don't get it. It does
right.
Nothing for me. It moves me not one inch, that stuff. And therefore, I didn't include it in my pick. I know there's obviously loads of people out there that get it and that do enjoy it, but there's an awful lot of people go around sort of going, oh, yeah, hip-hop and rap, it's really cool. It's like, do you actually like it?
But have you actually really listened to some of the lyrics? I mean, you know, because like Tupac, it's incredible, some of his stuff. I mean, really, if you sit and listen to it, and then you can really understand a lot of the stuff that he went through, you know, it's just...
Yeah, but to me, music is more, it's more than just lyrics. In fact, even as a singer, lyrics are actually one of the least important things on the record.
For some people, I guess.
I guess for some people.
Come over here.
No, music, I think that rap and hip-hop is defining of the 90s, and I think that it is poetry.
Do you like it?
Do I like it? I like some of it. I can't say
that's
that my...
That's a cop-out. You go home and you go like, oh, wow, I've got to listen to some Snoop Doggy Dogg and Tupac and everything
well,
else.
It's not my
cup. I don't do that.
But I don't think that I expect everyone to like my music either.
No, sure.
But
everyone does.
Not everyone likes Iron Maiden.
Well, but
the
thing
absolutely.
Is but you can only talk... But you can only...
No,
you can
but you
but
feel
music is something you should feel passionate about,
right?
Not something you
but
should
some
you should
do.
Say you should sort of go, well, you know, hello, yes, bless your pointed little head. I don't understand your music, but I do feel it's important. That's crap.
No,
that's
but you're
patronizing.
You're not talking about the artists. You're not talking about Snoop Dogg and Dr. Dre. You're not talking about the people who make
you
this
want
music.
I want somebody to sit here who was from there, being passionate about his music, defending it, and saying, no, this is why it's cool. This is why I do it. Then I'd understand it.
Trust me, they're very passionate
about it.
It comes from a very real place.
It's their lives, man. It's about what they see. I mean, that's...
But all I'm saying is that for me, the tune's the thing.
Mm. No, absolutely. You're talking about you didn't pick any because they're not your defining albums from the 90s.
Absolutely.
Okay. Just to clarify that, we don't want any bomb threats. Okay.
Are you in therapy? I'm just curious.
Am I in therapy?
There's this thing called anger management that a lot of rock and roll stars are now getting involved in.
Are they really?
That's back over pathetic. Here.
Only when forced by the courts.
You should watch Felicity.
Now comes the part. Now comes the fun part. The fun part is now the elimination round. Kind of poignant. Four picks have to go. And Robby, let's start with you.
Okay. I am vaguely familiar with a couple of those records. Catherine Wheel record, I'm not too familiar with, although I love Chrome, I love Black Metallic, I love all that stuff. Tidal as well, I'm not all that familiar with. But I am familiar with Natalie Merchant, being from the Western New York area, as I am. And I think some of the greatest work she did was with the Maniacs. And I think that, although a very good record, lots of hit songs, it's been on the radio a lot, very successful for her, I think I'm going to have to eliminate Tiger Lily.
Mm-hmm. What happens to me when that happens?
Nothing.
You have to hang upside
down. Do I lose a limb or
something? Thanks a lot for
nothing.
Coming.
You're fine.
You see that big sword that's hanging up there in the studio room?
You're going to be flying.
Greg, get my mug. Greg, it's your turn to knock one out.
Boy. I'm gonna have to eliminate Bad Motorfinger.
Oh, you suck.
Just because you attacked me so hard on the hip-hop thing.
I didn't attack you.
This is a personal vendetta against you.
Allie?
What is this anger management stuff? You'd have one of those mic stands through your head. I mean...
Allie? No anger.
Allie?
No anger.
No anger.
He's okay.
You can eliminate one now.
Right, I'm going to give you a pamphlet after the show. Okay, I don't know what 90% of these are now without the actual group.
Okay.
Is there...
Which one do you want to
eliminate? I'm just going to... Because I know that everyone's going to eliminate all of mine, I'm just going to go ahead and kill my number two.
Mutually assured destruction.
Wait, so you took off Natalie Merchant?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, here it comes. I'm going to get it.
All right. So let's just take off Fiona Apple. Just take all the girls off.
No, you don't have to. You know what? Don't take Fiona Apple.
All right, honey. I'm back. Yeah. I think I'm going to take Jagged Little Pill.
Ooh.
No. I'm joking.
You're joking. Okay.
Let's just take Fiona Apple off because he's going to kick my ass anyway. And I don't want to piss you guys off. So I'm going to take Fiona Apple off.
Okay, take Fiona off.
What a wimp. What a wimp. Stand by your selections.
Oh, I'm a weak person, Greg.
You guys should... Both get some pamphlets.
or get married, one or the other.
Yeah, exactly.
Depression management, anger management. Now's your chance.
It's like an encounter group.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick Jagged Little Pill. I'm gonna wink, wink, wink. I'm gonna yank Jagged Little Pill.
So what? You stand up, you're gonna beat me up?
Because I didn't. Yeah, it's because you're small.
That's an Iron Maiden.
I may be small in some areas,
she's big, you know.
But, okay, now let's give a voice to our viewers. We've been conducting a poll on VH1.com all week, and here's what you at home have voted to add to the list. Pearl Jam, 10. Yeah. Okay, let's take a look at the final list. Happy Days, Catherine Wheel. Nevermind, Nirvana. No Fences, Garth Brooks. Odelay, Beck. OK Computer, Radiohead. The Bends, Radiohead. The Downward Spiral, Nine Inch Nails. Version 2.0, Garbage. And 10, Pearl Jam. During the commercial break, our studio audience will cast their votes for the top three best albums of the 90s. But first, here's Stir performing the single New beginning. Audiences, cast their votes. Okay, drum roll, please. Here is the list of the best album of the 1990s. But wait, a strong write-in vote for Dizzy Up the Girl by the Goo Goo Dolls. Number three.
My album? Can anyone come in with
yes,
my album?
Yes, dear, your album was number one. Number three is a tie. Number three is a tie between Garth Brooks, No Fences, and OK Computer, Radiohead.
That's right.
Yes, that was it.
The thunder rolls and the lightning strikes. This is what you get. This is what you get.
You had bends, right?
Oh, it's a bend.
Right,
number two.
Computer. I'm cool. I'm cool. I can't believe it.
Number two, 10, Pearl Jam. And the number one choice for best album of the 90s, Nirvana. Never mind. I want to thank each of our fabulous guests, our studio audience, and you at home for participating in this special episode of The List. Now we have Stir taking us out with one of the biggest hits of the 1990s, Nirvana's In Bloom. See you in the next time on The List. Take it away, you guys.